Here we're provided a graph of f prime, and then they're going to ask us some questions about f of x. All right, for this problem in particular, we're being asked, where does f of x have a relative maximum, and where does it have a relative minimum? So let's just think about this for a minute. If you recall the first derivative test, we figured out that if a function f of x goes from increasing to decreasing, through a critical value. So if it passes a critical value and it's continuous and it goes from increasing to decreasing, you must have a maximum. But if it goes from decreasing to increasing, right, decreasing to increasing, you're at the lower point of a graph and you would have a relative minimum here. So first step is let's see if we can find any critical values. Now, what were critical values again? Well, you recall a critical value was a place where the derivative was either zero or undefined or did not exist. And so let's look on this graph here and see, where is the derivative zero, or where is the derivative, you know, undefined? Well, here the derivative is zero right here. Now, at first glance, if you're not paying attention, you would say, well, Devin, no, the slope is not zero there. Well, let's clarify. The slope of the derivative is not zero, but f prime itself is zero. So that means this is a critical value. Let's clarify. This is a critical value of the original function, right? Because the derivative equals zero. It's an x-intercept of the first derivative. Okay, so this guy is likely or could be a max or a min, but we're not really sure. We need to see what's happening on either side of 4. So before 4, f prime is positive, right, because it's above the x-axis. And after 4, f prime is negative because it's below the x-axis. So what does that reveal about f? Well, before 4, having positive derivatives means that it's increasing. And then after 4, having negative derivatives means that the original function is decreasing, indicating we've got ourselves a relative maximum at x equals 4. Now, as far as relative minimums go, I don't see any place where the derivatives go from negative to positive. See, down here, the derivatives are negative. I don't ever see them turning around and being positive again. I don't see that ever happening. Looks like this is just a straight line, at least as far as we can see. So relative minimums that we're aware of, there are no relative mins.